All right, Ken, I've mentioned this a few times this morning. I'm going to mention it real quick, just one more time. Thomas Rhett's concert in St. Paul was supposed to be this Friday. He has postponed it.
I think you're just so heartbroken about this.
It hurts a little because every single time I've ever tried to see him, something has happened.
At least it's not canceled. It's just postponed,
yeah,
right?
It's just postponed. So the new date is going to be Wednesday, November 29th at the XL Energy Center. So it's in the same place, Wednesday, November 29th. He didn't give many details. He just said that he is sick. It's postponed due to illness. But yes, he is coming back. And he had to reschedule a few other dates too. Why are you laughing?
I just realized that instead of doing Lauren's Country Lowdown, we did the B105 Buzz here.
Oh.
Did you notice that?
Now that you mention it, yeah.
Hold on, a do-over.
Okay.
Get the inside scoop on your favorite artist, Lauren's Country Lowdown.
Wow. Did you just snore?
Okay, yeah, I do that sometimes. Hey, here's your Country Lowdown. That sounds better now.
All right. My bad. I already mentioned Thomas Rhett. His concert has been postponed.
Okay.
Wednesday, November 29th. Moving on. Actually, a really cool story. Kenny Chesney is playing at U.S. Bank Stadium.
Yeah.
We're giving away tickets all week. His crew came to U.S. Bank Stadium to address the sound issue because
they've had some pretty big problems.
Yeah, a lot of people have complained at previous concerts that the acoustics are kind of bad there. So his crew already has visited the venue. They spent a long day this week, according to the Star Tribune, walking to every corner of the stadium. They did audio tests, and they apparently left feeling confident that they can make the concert sound great for everybody. So more details on that and the Thomas Rhett story on KKCB.com. But I think that's amazing. And his crew does have the reputation of being one of the best crews.
Well, hopefully then they can kind of share that with other places.
Yep.
Because it's how sad is it to get this brand new stadium built and the acoustics are terrible.
Yeah. I've never been to a concert there.
So hopefully they fix it, yeah.
Yeah, so they said that they feel positive about it, so that's good news. And more good news, let's talk about the CMAs for a second, because a lot of performers have slowly been announced, but now they're pairing up different superstars, and I'm pretty excited. Maren Morris and Niall Horan from One Direction, they have a new song out.
So they do?
Yeah, so they're teamed up.
You know what a huge One Direction fan I am.
Well, Maren Morris. But, I mean, yeah, I know how much you sing One Direction all the time.
I don't know a single.
I know you do.
Isn't it Paper Angels? Angels something?
Anyway,
I don't know.
No, I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about. But they will probably sing their duet. Brad Paisley and Kane Brown. Kelsey Ballerini, Reba McEntire.
Oh, that'd be good.
Yeah, and Dierks Bentley and Rascal Flatts. And then other people that are going to be performing. Thomas Rhett, Eric Church, Miranda, Garth Carey. And those are on November 8th, so they're coming up. But I love the superstar pairings.
Yeah, that'd be good.
So,
looking forward to the CMAs. You stay up late that night and watch them all?
Well, we have our Everybody Wins party, but I will.
But the CMAs, you have to go to like 10 o'clock?
Yeah, I definitely always stay up and watch.
All right,
I'm
cool.
So into it.
Are you going to tweet? You should live tweet it this year.
I always do. But
you
I'll
do?
Tweet from B105 Twitter account this time.
Oh, well, okay. Well, make sure.
Get excited for some tweets.
We'll just make sure she's not drinking before during the CMAs.
some truth might come out.
All right. No. All right, that's your Lauren's Country Lowdown. Thanks, Lauren.